We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
This is Indian Tyler's Beyond the Vanity, where we explore the depths of beauty from various angles of the mirror. It's BTV. Get ready to see the beauty and your reflection in a whole new light. Ladies and gentlemen, let's please welcome Indian Tyler.
Welcome, beautiful. Thank you so much for tuning in and being part of our broadcast today on Indian Tyler's Beyond the Vanity. I'm Indian Tyler, beauty product expert and your professional brand consultant. And this is the show where we talk about beauty. We have real conversations about real life beauty, the inner, the outer, and everything we try so very hard to cover up. Today we have a very touching segment in store for you. According to the Renfrey Center for Eating Disorders, Eating Disorders 101 Guide, overeating disorders affect up to 24 million Americans and 70 million individuals worldwide. The book Big Fat Lies, The Truth About Your Weight and Your Health, reports a study which found that one half of females between the ages of 18 to 25 who participated in the study would prefer to be run over by a truck. They would prefer to be run over by a truck than to be fat. And two-thirds surveyed would rather be mean or stupid. Now, that's very alarming and very shocking. And today we have the Celestin twins, Nikisha and Nicole, and they have taken a stance and actually developed a cinematic short film about this riveting issue. So we'll be talking with them a little later. First, we want to talk about a few things that have been in the news. Today is Red Wrap Wednesday. It marks the 1 month day that fateful day that the Nigerian girls were abducted. And a lot of people have been asking, well, what can I do? How can I be involved? How can I take a stance on the issue? I wanted to tell you that you can go to facebook.com/bringbackourgirls and you can actually create your very own event. All you have to do is choose a date, a time, a location, and a date that's in the next 5 days from when you contact them. And then you just tell all of your friends to join. And then you send the info to facebook.com/bringbackourgirls. And they will create an event page and help promote. They also have visual images that you can use as posters. So, you know, you definitely want to ask people to wear red. And you also want to definitely promote your event within your various networks. So there are things that you can do to help in the plight to bring back our girls. It's been a month and we definitely need them back in their homes and with their families. So keep your prayers and keep them uplifted as, you know, the struggle continues. So that's why I'm wearing my red head wrap today. Definitely want to bring back the girls, want to see them get back into safety and into the comfort of their own homes. In hot topic news, switching gears just a little bit, to kind of somber up the mood and add a little bit of joy into this. Angelina Jolie had a little bit of a face powder faux pas earlier this week at the premiere of her husband's new film, The Normal Heart in New York. If you head on over to our Facebook page, facebook.com/itsbtv, you'll see the picture. And, you know, when I first looked at the picture, I was like, okay, that's pretty bad. When I looked at the picture a second time, I was like, ooh. Now, don't get me wrong. Angelina Jolie has many passes in my book. I mean, she graces the cover of the June issue of Elle like it's no one's business. She's giving you face, grace, body, everything. So she definitely gets a pass for this. The problem that I have is with her makeup artist. Now, it was only a couple of weeks ago that we had this same issue in London when there was a photo call for Maleficent that Miss Jolie had some press powder on her knees and her shins. So this seems like it's a reoccurring thing. Definitely take a look over on our Facebook page and see what it is that I'm talking about. Ladies out there, okay, so when you use the universal or the invisible loose powder, just be careful. Be very careful because, I mean, traditionally it's been a problem for women of color because it just makes us look ashy, just point blank, period. No way around it. It makes us look bad, especially if you do not choose the right one. It can definitely make you look like Casper the Friendly Ghost in a photo. So that's not what you want. But Angelina Jolie is pale. So that goes to the point that no one is exempt. So when you use universal loose powder, just be very careful. Blend it in. Don't just dust it upon yourself and make it look like you have cornstarch on yourself. You know, blend that thing. Blend it. And if it's not looking right, take it off. It's makeup. You can put some more on. Okay, so next up, over 60 models were arrested in China. Many of them were from the U.S. and Europe. Okay, so basically these girls, they were working on tourist visas, which are easier to get in China, apparently, and they got busted. So the Beijing police, they staged a fake model casting at the Chinese agency M3. And four models have reportedly been jailed, and some of the models are actually snitching and giving up like where these model houses are. So the moral to this story is, if you're on a visa, be on the right visa. Don't try to go overseas, work in a completely different country on an inappropriate visa. It just doesn't work out. And you can be tall, slim, thin, and beautiful, and you are not exempt. We've got models here who are in China now who are jailed because they were working on the wrong visa. So just, you know, if you're going to work overseas, just do it the right way. You don't want to be overseas in jail. I mean, this is terrible. And I mean, models, a lot of them are very, you know, are younger, they're underage or they're just of age. So our hearts go out to them. But definitely, if you're working overseas, work on the right visa, please. And I fault a lot of their management because it was actually their management and their representation that was actually advocating that these girls work off of these tourist visas because they were easier to get. So the models themselves are not the only people at fault here, but it's also their management too. So just be careful. Be very, 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 very careful. Okay, so I would be remiss without talking about this whole Jay-Z and Beyonce and Solange elevator situation. Couple of things. I know you all have heard about it. Basically, it happened. And I don't personally think, because Beyonce has been getting a lot of flack and so has Jay-Z. Jay-Z, from the standpoint that a lot of men are saying, well, why didn't he hit her? Why didn't he do this? Imagine if Jay-Z had really hit Solange. He better thank God. I mean, God, that he didn't even look like he was going to strike her, because if he did, this whole situation would have turned out very, very, very terrible for Jay-Z. So Jay-Z, kudos to you. Bravo that, you know, you didn't go ham on Solange. We don't know why Solange went ham. There's so many different speculations and theories out there that are circulating. But the fact of the matter is, I have a sister. And I know that there have been a couple of boyfriends that I wanted to smack down, beat down, and do some other stuff too. So, I mean, if you have a sister and either you feel like your sister is being mistreated or your boyfriend or your husband or whatever disrespects you, your sister is not supposed to really jump in, especially when there is a trained, probably highly paid security guard right there. Beyonce, clap, clap. You did not get involved. Good for you. Move your dress out the way and let it play out. Because what would have happened is, if Jay-Z would have hurt her, Solange, or if Beyonce would have jumped in, this situation would have turned out totally differently. So I pray for them. I hope that they can mend their family ties, whatever it is. Next time, TMZ, please get some audio. Please. We need audio, because everybody has their own theory about why this whole situation even happened. So TMZ, definitely, we need some audio for that one. But anyway, that's Hot Topics. And when we come back, we will be talking with Nakisha and Nicole Celestin about their short film, The B Word. We will later on in the broadcast be joined by Shayla Hale, who was one of the lead actresses in the film. So definitely stay tuned. We will be right back after a very short break.
And that's exactly what I need to do if I
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hey, it's your girl Indian Tyler here, reminding you that our conversation continues all week long on our social media platforms, and we are It's BTV on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. So just head on over to twitter.com/ITSBTV, facebook.com/ITSBTV, and also Instagram. And our profile there is ITSBTV. That stands for Indian Tyler's Beyond the Vanity. Join the conversation all week long. And remember, always go beyond the vanity. Want to perk up your senses with a fragrance that is fresh, invigorating, and revitalizing? Want soft, smooth skin that is hydrated and healthy looking? A Girl's Gotta Spa believes that your personal well-being should be a priority, and that includes pampering yourself with naturally luxurious, gentle, effective bath and body products. A Girl's Gotta Spa Energizing Citrus is a harmonious blend of 100% pure essential oils of pink grapefruit, orange, lemon, and lime. The body wash treats the skin and enlightens the senses, while the body lotion absorbs easily to help restore your skin's natural moisture balance. Vegan and Leaping Bunny certified, A Girl's Gotta Spa is available at www.agirlsgottaspa.com/store. That's www.agirlsgottaspa.com/store. A Girl's Gotta Spa, energizing citrus body wash and lotion. You deserve to be pampered.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody.
Welcome back to Indian Tyler's Beyond the Vanity. And we are here. We have double the trouble, double the beauty, and double the fun. We have got the Celestin twins, Nakisha and Nicole, here in our studio, and they're going to tell us all about their wonderful short cinematic project, The B Word. So, ladies, hello.
Hi. Thank you for having us. We're excited to be here.
Well, thank you for coming in. I really appreciate that. And guys, just understand that, like, they have the same voice. So they're going to have to start off by saying, like, I'm Nicole, I'm Nakisha, or this is Nicole, this is Nakisha. So we're not trying to, this is not radio for dummies. This is just to help you out to know who's talking.
Yeah, exactly.
So, ladies, tell us, what propelled you into creating The B Word?
I'll actually let you answer that because it was your idea. This is Nicole speaking.
And now this is Nakisha. Nicole was away at USC getting her master's, and I was living in back in Maryland. And we would see each other not so often as we used to see each other. She came back home very thin, big head, big hair, and I noticed a difference in her physique. She was very, very slim. So my mom and I had a discussion amongst ourselves to try to figure out what was going on. She didn't have the same eating habits when she came home, so we thought maybe something's wrong. So we did the research to try to figure out, is this something that a young black woman would go through coming from, you know, kind of the South or coming from the East Coast and then going to LA where you want to be thin and all those different images are in your head. So we had the conversation and talked to my sister about it, and thank God, you know, it wasn't something she was suffering from. But we noticed the numbers were kind of out there that young black women in low-income communities were going through it. So that's when we started the project.
Now, Nicole, how did you respond to this quote-unquote family intervention? And for listeners, the B word does not stand for
what you think it
dummy mom with itch, okay? It stands for bulimia.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So what was your reaction when Nikisha and the other family members came to you and said, hey, we think there might be a problem?
I think I had the same reaction that everyone else does when you think about African-American women who are suffering with bulimia. I'm like, we don't do that. We're not throwing up our food. That's quote-unquote a white girl's disease. Black women don't do that. Mm-hmm. So when they approached me with that, you know, I was like, that's not what's happening. But, you know, we had the discussion, and I said, you know what, this is something we have to tell, because as my sister said, no one would think that we would go through this. Even right. I didn't. I had the same response that everyone else had. So I was like, yes, Keisha, let's write this.
Right. And, you know, when you had that response, this is something we had to tell. A lot of times people, you know, they'll hear sad things or they'll learn about, you know, a societal ill and it just stops there. It's kind of like, oh, I'm just sad. That's it. Mm-hmm. What was that motivating thing that led you to develop this project?
I would say just being in entertainment, period. We see a lot of films, TV shows that don't really mean anything. Mm-hmm. And our goal is always, if we can help one person, then it was worth it. So to me, that was the reason I wanted to do it.
And also, this is Nikisha. We have 5 nieces. I guess we're about to have 6 now. And
it's a boy.
Congrats. Oh,
that's right.
It's a boy.
Congratulations on your nephew.
It's a boy.
I can't keep up. We have 7 brothers.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, big family. And
what
you know,
is that like?
Girl, offline will tell you.
But, you know, one of our younger nieces, we were out eating. I think we were eating something that wasn't healthy that day.
We were at Wendy's.
Yeah. She said, Auntie, you know, I want to go do a walk after this because I want to work off my food. At the time, I think Ryan was 5, maybe.
Yeah.
And already. And I'm like, no, we can't have these. I mean, we are all about being healthy and working out and all that. But her sense wasn't about being healthy. It was about her outer appearance. So we definitely just, we had that conversation with her as well. She was only 5 years old.
Now,
so.
Did this happen before or after the situation with Nicole?
This happened before.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
so it was another reason why we wanted to do the project. And hopefully when we go home in August for our mom's 50th birthday party, we can show all of our nieces and start that conversation, because they're all young, under 10. So we can start that conversation with them right now and let them know this isn't healthy. You want to eat right, you do it this way. You don't throw up your food and, you know, counting calories at 5. I don't want to put those images out there.
Can you even count that high at 5?
She watches what she eats.
Really?
At 5.
At 5 years old.
At 5 years old.
She wants to be a singer. So it's like, I want to look like this. So, yeah, but people also don't understand that it's not also about the physical aspect. It's also a mental thing. Like, if you're counting calories or if you're throwing up your food or if you think you're bigger than what you are, it's a mental illness. It's not basically just physical.
And to have a sense of how your body is at 5, it really, really bothers me. So I really wanted to make this project just so we can show our nieces. If no one else in the world sees it, as long as my 5 nieces see this project and we can have that conversation, I'll be completely happy.
Now, as both of you are writers and producers, there obviously was a certain level of research that you had to do before creating the project.
Mm-hmm.
How did you go about doing the research?
This is Nicole. It was very hard.
It was this Nikisha. We were pulling out our hair. There really aren't any statistics for African-American women or women of color. I think we found something in 2009.
Yeah, and that was the study.
And it was
study.
Only for 2,300 girls. Yeah. And then if you go back further, it was in the 1990s, and we're in 2014. So I just feel like we should have more information that consists of everyone, every color, every ethnic group, because they aren't representing us.
And what were some of the...
Sorry, this is Nicole. There was actually a movie that came on Lifetime called Starving in Suburbia. I didn't watch it, but did you end up watching it? I don't think we were in that as well. Like,
No, I watched some of it. You know, when she went to a support group to talk about what was going on with her.
Who is
she? It wasn't the main character.
Okay, in the movie, the main character.
Yeah, okay. We weren't represented in that support group. So I didn't see any brown or black faces. So it's like, you're still not including us.
Wow.
So I just want people to know we are going through this. Most people think, oh, black women want to be voluptuous, the hips and the butt. And if we're naturally like that, it's fine. But most women, most black women are going through this too. We don't all want to be just curvy and be voluptuous.
Now, what were some of the statistics that you did find?
We found one that said African-American women were 153% more to get it than our counterparts, than white women and Latina women.
Okay, give that
women.
To me again.
153% more.
So but we're 150%.
53%.
53%
correct.
More likely to develop the disease,
mm-hmm.
but in all of the interventions and things of that nature, mm-hmm. we are not represented.
No, at all. And these statistics are coming from a lower income bracket. So it's not in affluent areas or suburbia. It's in the hood, like places
wow.
where you wouldn't think it would come from.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, we're struggling with so many issues within our own little four blocks that you have to add that on to it.
Wow. Some of the statistics that I've found were that the diet and diet related industry is a $50 billion a year enterprise.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just the diet and diet related industry in and of itself. I think that that is incredibly alarming. And in addition to that, 42% of first through third grade girls want to be thinner.
Mm-hmm. And I'll be completely honest, before we started doing this research, I was one of the people that would eat terribly for a weekend and say, oh, I'll just take some laxatives and flush out my system.
I'll go get a colon cleanse.
Exactly. But these are things that women who suffer from these eating disorders do, and I had no idea. So you're subconsciously doing these things that are unhealthy, and unless you do the research and try to figure it out, you have no idea. So it's something that I don't do anymore, but I had no idea that that was one of the risk factors or one of the symptoms that women with eating disorders do.
Now, have either of you been affected by someone else's life who was going through or struggling with a eating disorder?
We haven't. This is Nicole, but coincidentally, we were on set, and one of our girlfriends came who's actually a twin, and she told us the story of her sister who's actually going through this. Her twin sister
wow.
is struggling from bulimia, and we've known her probably for the last 10 years, you know, in and out of our lives.
You've known the sister
knew.
Or?
No, we've known the twin sister.
Okay.
But
okay.
We don't know her twin sister. But we've known her, and we've never knew this. And actually, a couple of our friends actually came up to us when we were filming who were actually on set with us. And was like, yeah, my friend's struggling from this, or my cousin, or so on and so on. I personally don't know anyone, but it's crazy of all the people who came to us and said, I know someone who is struggling with this, and they are brown or black.
Yeah, once we started campaigning and doing our Kickstarter videos, people would instant message and direct message us and say, you know, I went through this in high school. Thank you for telling this story. We just got a lot of testimony, which made us want to do it even more.
Mm-hmm. Now, what was the Kickstarter process like for you all? I mean, you guys are no novice to production. I mean, you are working currently on Love and Hip Hop Hollywood.
Yeah.
And Nikisha, you've just, God dang, your resume is sick.
I've been blessed.
Yeah, she's worked on My Flipping Family, Back to Me with Jeanette Jenkins. She was also a segment producer for both Being and Vindicated. So you guys work in production.
Mm-hmm.
You know what it takes. But what was it like having to start from the grassroots and enter into the Kickstarter process?
I would say it was a blessing because once you're in the entertainment industry, you build this network.
Mm-hmm.
So if you call out to certain people, you know, I'm shooting this weekend. Can you come help? We need some equipment. Can we get a discount? We need to get craft services. What restaurant owners do we know? So I think for us, it was a good
blessing,
experience.
Yeah,
and then
go ahead.
So cute.
I think it was a good experience. And once you tell people what the project is about and the message you're trying to get out, they want to help you even more.
And I was just going to say, we were able to reach out to a lot of the equipment houses and previous people we've worked with in the business who were like, okay, I'll help you. You don't have to pay me or give me a half day rate.
Okay.
So to me, that was a blessing because people saw the project and they wanted to work with us and also the actors and producers on the project as well.
Now, if you haven't seen the trailer for The B Word, it is on our Facebook page. So you can head on over to facebook.com/itsbtv and the trailer is up. Now, I know the full-length short is not available to date. When will it be available?
I think we're releasing in October. Right now we're in the process of submitting to different film festivals, and they don't like it to be screened until you screen it at their festival. But by in the fall, I think we should release it.
Definitely.
And you'll be able to find it on our website, which is celestintwins.com.
Okay. And now I've seen the film, and it's good. It's very touching. It really is. And there are a lot of different layers to it that I think that most people don't think about when they think about eating disorders. Mm-hmm. I mean, when I watched it, I thought about revenge, family ties, you know, healing and not healing, mm-hmm. and all of those other things that you would traditionally not associate with eating disorders. Mm-hmm. What can you tell us about the film?
What can we tell you
without giving the story away?
Yes.
We can tell you we have amazing, amazing actors in our film. Shayla, who you'll meet later, Shima, Desiree, who's a new young actress who I'm sure you'll see more of, and Lamone, who's from Young and the Restless. And basically the story is about, you know, a sisterhood, a bond, and coming, writing that story, it was about us because we're very, very close, to the point some people think it's unhealthy.
A little weird, right?
But we're very, very close, and I always think to myself, if my sister was going through that, how would I be able to help her through that? So that's where I was coming from writing that, and if she would actually be receptive to my help. Mm-hmm. So that's something that we go through in the film, and once you watch it, you'll understand and kind of put yourself in those character shoes.
And this is Nicole. I can say you won't expect the ending.
I can say that too.
Yeah, that's one thing I can say. You won't expect the ending.
I was not expecting that.
And we're all about... We hate happy endings, kind of.
Yeah, I hate happy endings. I want someone to be crying. I want somebody to die.
It's unrealistic. I mean, everyone's happy.
There are happy endings in life, but in most of my films or television, I'd rather see someone die.
We want you to get the grit of the story.
And the grit you do get. Now, is there going to be a follow-up to the B-word, or is the short all we get?
I think the short is all you get. Even though it's a short, you get the characters and you get more background in it. So I think we've told that story, but we have so much more we want to do and so many different stories that we want to tell. So I think the B word, you know, I think that would be the end for it.
Yeah. I mean, we just started the process of actually showing people the film. So, I mean, you never know. Like, once it gets to a certain stage, we may say, you know what, let's write the feature. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I won't say it won't happen.
Okay.
Okay.
So what can we expect? You said you have a lot of other stories that you want to tell. Can you tell us anything about those upcoming stories?
I can. We're excited. Nicole is actually going to direct our next project, which is entitled Layers. It's about a young woman who has alopecia. And if you don't know what that is, it's a scarring in your scalp. So most women, you know, and this ties into your show about vanity. They think most women want to, you know, wear the weaves, and most women have to wear it because they're dealing with alopecia and their hair isn't growing in certain spots and baldness and all that stuff.
Or it's affecting their hair because they are wearing the weaves. Because
exactly.
You cannot have alopecia. You can actually get it from wearing too many weaves, and it can start messing up your hair.
Tension alopecia.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So that's, I was talking to one of my girlfriends, and she was telling me a story of how her friend was engaged to be married, and her husband had never seen her real hair. So she wanted to show her husband what she looked like before they actually got married. So I was like, you know what? I think I'm going to write a script about that.
That's awesome. Is that what the basis of the
script
is?
That's what the script is about, yes.
Oh, I'm excited. Now, when do you guys go into production for that?
We're actually in pre-production now, and we shoot on June 14th and 15th. So I'm really excited.
Very excited.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And that will be a short as well. And our next feature project, which Nicole is writing right now, Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fantasies.
Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fallacies.
Fallacies, I'm sorry.
Wait a minute, say that again. Back up the bus. You know we gotta go slow sometimes here.
Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fallacies.
Okay. I have my own feelings about what it could be about.
See,
but
it's
tell
what
it.
You think it's about.
Right.
It's about the 1980s drug situation. You would never think that, right?
No, that's not where my mind is going.
And then going back to our social conscious issues, there's a character who's a cutter. So we go into that mental illness as well.
And
as
this
far
is in Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fallacies.
Yes.
Wait, I'm going to get this. Hold on.
Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fallacies. You got it.
Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fallacies.
Yes.
I like that.
Thank
She used to say this to me all the time. I would say something, she'd be like, Lies, Fairy Tales, and Fallacies. So I just took it, and that's the name of my next script.
I'm going to see you check for that.
Yeah, no.
I want to check for that.
It's all under the same umbrella, so you good.
So, like I was saying, that one of the characters is a cutter, so we talk about a mental illness as well. So all the projects that come from Celestin & Company Films will have some type of social conscious issue or some type of mental illness, just so we put it out there. Because most people, we don't talk about it in the Black community. Are you, right. you going to a therapist? Oh, no, don't tell nobody. You know, we don't have those conversations. So we're all about talking and have those conversations.
And that was one of the things that I found interesting about the B word was the reaching out for help and mm-hmm. where the characters chose to reach out mm-hmm. for help and how they sought help, even though that they knew they had a problem, the avenues that they chose to pursue. So is that a theme that we can see recurring in your projects?
Definitely.
Okay.
And also, unfortunately, because of this disease, it's not just 12 months. It can be for a lifetime, but we, as I'm not going to say we are all broke, but who can actually pay for this for over their lifetime? So that's, I think that's another reason people aren't getting treatment, because who can afford it? It's like you can either go to get treatment or you can go to college. Like, which one is it?
Right.
And had that been you, our parents would have sent you either to rehab or to college.
Exactly.
So that's something that you have to think about as well, is when you want to get help, can I afford help? Because this isn't something that's going to, I'll go to therapy and it's done in 3 months. It's something you constantly struggle with.
We had a guest on last week's show who had struggled with bulimia, and that was one of the things that she mentioned. If you missed it, definitely go to beyondthevanity.com and check out our In Case You Missed It episode about celibacy. One of the young ladies had struggled with bulimia, and that was one of the things that she continued to say mm-hmm. was that the struggle
It continues. Yeah, it's just like AA, narcotics, anything, whatever disease you're struggling with, it's not going to be a pill that's just going to cure it. Mm-hmm. Like, you have to take it one day at a time.
Definitely.
And what were some of the shocking things that you found in developing this film, be it statistics or personal experiences from people who came up to you?
This is Nikisha. Something that I found was very alarming. You can go to YouTube and there are young girls who put out videos to show you how to binge.
Ooh.
So they're telling you, you know, which finger to use or mm-hmm. what you can eat that comes down, that doesn't come up chunky, or what you can do. And I'm like, people are actually going here and trying to figure out. There's a website dedicated to if you're bulimic, but not in a good way. It's mm-hmm. not supporting you. It's teaching you different ways.
Wow.
So once I saw that, I'm like, we have to get this out here.
Well, thank you, ladies, for definitely creating this project. And more with the Celestin Twins right after this very short break.
Staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Want clean, fresh, young-looking skin? Want a product that actually works but doesn't have harsh, irritating chemicals that you can't pronounce? Finally, there's a lightweight, oil-free facial moisturizer that gently exfoliates to reveal glowing, baby-soft skin. Award-winning beauty blogger Jen Matthews and a team of chemists have created the ultimate moisturizer for all skin types. Plus, it's vegan and never tested on animals. Go to www.mybeautybunny.com to learn more. That's www.mybeautybunny.com. My Beauty Bunny, all natural exfoliating moisturizer, your new beauty secret.
Reality radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. You're tuned in to LA Talk Live, where we're more than just talk.
Back to Indian Tyler's Beyond the Vanity. I am your host, Indian Tyler, beauty product expert and professional brand consultant. And today we are talking all about the B word with the Celestin twins, Nakisha and Nicole. And it's not the B word that rhymes with stitch. It's the B word that stands for bulimia. So hello, Nakisha. Hello, Nicole.
Hello.
And we are joined by the lovely Miss Shayla Howe, who actually was one of the lead actresses in the film The B Word. Hello, Shayla.
Hello.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Your character in the film was rather interesting.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about your artistic process as you prepared for this film.
Wow. I started off by going to my coach, and we broke down the character. We tried to find the reasons why she was doing the things that she was doing. And then after that, we started a discussion, and it made me go to YouTube. Mm-hmm. And Nakisha said earlier that there are videos on YouTube that teach you how to go through bulimia. And it was very emotional mm-hmm. for me, because at first I couldn't understand why they were doing it. And my mother is a guidance counselor, and she kind of broke it down to me and said that it's more about controlling. It's a control issue. And in the short, you can see that something is going on between the two sisters, and they have to deal with something. And my character has a control issue. She doesn't know how to control her life, so she's spiraling, and what she can control is what goes in her mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And watching these girls eat and eat and eat, it like you can't fathom how they do it, because they're eating amounts of food that a normal person cannot eat in one sitting. A mm-hmm. football player couldn't eat in one sitting. One girl sat there for 10 minutes and ate a variety of foods that didn't make any sense. They didn't match. You know, no peanut butter, but you got bread and jelly. Like, just
right.
eating and stuffing. And then
and this
she,
is in the film.
In the film.
Mm-hmm.
You can go to YouTube, Google it, and see it for yourself. And
not the B word, but this is in your research.
My research,
right.
My research.
Mm-hmm.
And she sat there, and then she drank water, which flushes it down, and it makes it easier for you to stick your finger down your throat and throw up what you just ate. So it's kind of like, I don't know, it's like National Geographic for animals or something, but it's a human being doing these acts. And what you don't realize, and I actually watching this and researching, I found out that some girls that I went to school with had it.
Wow. And you didn't know it at the time.
I didn't know it at the time, but I knew something was wrong. One of my roommates, I would hear her throwing up, and I thought, oh, okay, whatever. I don't maybe she's sick. I didn't think anything of it. But you can tell by their fingernails. You can tell by the scarring on their hands. Their teeth are stained. One girl in the video, in one of the videos, said that she has neurological problems. She can't even look far right or far left because she has headaches from that. And you don't realize that you're doing this to your body. They have no idea what they're doing for long term. And you just, I say this all the time, you just want to jump through the screen and give them a hug and save them and say, please stop. You don't know what you're doing to yourself. You look fine. You're beautiful as is.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Obviously, being a beautiful girl yourself,
you're thank you.
Stunning and gorgeous.
Thank you.
How was it getting into character, jumping into the skin of a character who didn't see herself as beautiful?
You know, we all have our own little hang-ups. Somebody might look at you and say, oh, you're perfect. I want what you have. And then that person in turn will be like, no, I want what you have. So I think everybody has something that they want to make better. Mm-hmm. Watching it myself, I didn't necessarily look at it as a beauty thing. It was more of a psychological thing. And I had to get the psychological aspect before I thought of anything else, because that's where the illness is. It's in your mind.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where you have to heal before you do anything else. So there, I have friends, or even myself, you know, you say you want to get plastic surgery on this and this. No, it's not the plastic surgery you need. It's the healing that you need.
That's not what you're really trying to fix.
Right.
Right.
Because once it starts, you do your lips, then it's your ears, and then it's your forehead. It
right.
is, it's just ridiculous stuff.
Right.
But it's not about that. It's about how you feel about yourself. It's your self-value,
mm-hmm.
you know, instead of whatever else you're dealing with.
Yeah, that goes to one of my favorite lines and one of my favorite Beyonce songs. I know we talked about it earlier in the hour, but the Pretty Hurt song.
Yeah.
Trying to fix what you can't see.
Mm-hmm.
It's a soul that needs a surgery
mm-hmm.
from Pretty Hurts. I love that part.
That's
because
funny that you said that, because the weekend that we were shooting, she just released that.
Wow.
Yeah. She just released that. So I was on set watching that video and playing it over and over mm-hmm. and over again. And Nikisha was like, can we not?
She's like, can we stop to Beyonce? Like, everybody was playing Beyonce somewhere.
Yeah.
But that song really fits to the theme.
It did. It did. It was right on time.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Wow. So what was it like being on set? Do you have siblings in you know, of your own?
Yes, I have an older sister.
Okay.
So I'm the baby.
Oh, wow.
So we switched
roles. So it switched.
Yeah.
Wow. So how was it being in the seat of an older sister?
It was weird because I'm used to being the baby.
Mm.
And so I had to kind of think about how my sister feels. And then I related it to my younger cousins, because
okay.
I feel like the older sibling to them, because my family is so close. We're not cousins. We're brothers and sisters.
Mm-hmm.
So I had to think about it like that. And how would I feel if I was in a situation with one of my little cousins that I, you know, kind of saw them, you know, when they were babies and coming up, and then I can't really, I'm trying not to tell the story.
Right, I know, we're all talking in code.
Right, right.
Dang it, girls. Celeste and Twins, you have to come back in October once everything is released.
Right, right. So, I mean, coming from that aspect, it was new, I'll say. And it was fun to do, to be bossy, because I'm always getting bossed around.
Oh, good. Now, you also star in Roomie, Love, and Friends.
Yes.
Love your character, Tomiko.
Thank
She's
you.
She's freaking hilarious. Like, I think there's, like, characteristics of Tomiko in all of us.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what can we expect from you in the near future?
Right now, I'm in training for another film called The Reason. It's a track film. And I always like to do things that have purpose and meaning. And this one is a girl trying to go to college. And she wants to get a scholarship through track. And her reason is to get out of her current situation. So the premise is everybody has a reason for what they do. So what's your reason?
Oh, wow. And when can we expect that?
We start filming the first 2 weeks of July, and we actually, I think she launched the Kickstarter already, or the Indiegogo campaign, but you can go to The Reason Film or The Reason Movie. The Reason Film is on Instagram. The Reason Movie is Facebook and Twitter, and
okay.
find out all about it. We also have a Nike contest going on, so you can win a free pair of Nike sneakers.
Hey!
Yeah.
This is Nicole. Shayla's also going to be one of my lead
yes,
actors.
So, okay, can I?
For layers?
Yes.
You can talk about it. Go for it.
Okay. With the alopecia stuff. So I just got a weave right. I hate fake stuff because I can't keep it on. Nails, even nail polish, it comes off in like 2 seconds. So the other day I got like the back of my hair, you know, tidied up.
Got some length back there. Right. Which is going on.
Right.
Okay.
Because I don't have a perm either. So my hair is curly. It just bushes up. But I don't know how to make it that cute curl look. Right. So my head is really tender and it pulls. And so I just got scared when she was talking about the pulling alopecia, the tension alopecia.
The tension alopecia.
I'm sitting here like, no, I gotta go to the dermatologist.
No, you're fine, honey. You are fine.
She's crazy.
No, you are so
it's
fine.
It's not just from one weave. It's habitual weave. Like four years ago,
I got one and
Stop
it was
it.
Pulling. And then now I'm like, Lord, no more weave.
No, you're fine. You're fine. It's habitual weave wearing. I will say, though, ladies out there, be careful with the weaves, though, because it's just like a perm. One bad weave can mess you up.
It can. So, and that's what the film is about. Like, you want this long hair, but at what cost? Where it's starting to affect your health.
Right. More from the Celestine twins and Shayla Howe right after this very short break. We're going to learn about what these lovelies have on their vanity. This is going to be very interesting. So definitely stay tuned. We'll be right back. Tuning in, I'm Indian Tyler, your beauty product expert and professional brand consultant, and we have been talking all about the short film, The B Word. B stands for bulimia. Come on, right? And we've been talking with Nikisha and Nicole Celestin, writers and producer, and Nicole, now writer, producer, and director.
Yes.
And also Shayla Howe, who was a lead actress on the film The B Word has some great projects coming up, including Layers.
Layers, yes.
So right now we want to take a minute and talk to these lovely ladies about what they have on their vanity. I'll kick it off and talk about what's on mine first to kind of get the platform all warm so they can get their stuff. I only have one product, so it's going to be real quick. What's on my vanity right now is real simple. Fiji water. You know what? And I know all about the carbon footprint and it takes so much money to get it over here and da-da-da-da-da. I know, and it's so bad,
but it tastes so
good.
Yes,
water is
my favorite water.
It is refreshing. It's great for the hair because it has silica in it. It's great for the hair, skin, and nails. It is like the best beauty water. I personally love it because I can just drink and drink and drink and drink and drink. Some waters, they go down and they feel kind of harsh. When I was living in London, my favorite water of choice was Volvic. But that was before I got turned on to the Fiji water. Mm-hmm. Ever since then, I've been hooked. My husband is like, why are we spending $11 for 6 liters of water, Indian? This is ridiculous. I'm like, oh, my God, babe, but you got to see what it's doing to my nails.
Yes. I bought them for set. And they were like, really, Nicole, you bought Fiji for set? I was like, this is my personal stash.
Yes. In 2 years, all of the guests will be going home with 6 liters. Yes. So give me some time, y'all. Yeah. 6 liters of Fiji water. So, guys, what is on your vanity? Nikisha.
My first product is Ambi.
which is a moisturizer for my face. I think the sun, it must be different out here from East Coast and out here.
Oh,
my
definitely.
Skin was getting so dry, so definitely the Ambi to keep my skin moisturized.
Is that any particular one? Which one is that?
It's called the Even Clear Daily Moisturizer. And just make sure it has SPF in it, because I go out hiking a lot, so I just make sure it has the sunscreen and all that good stuff
Now, do
in
you
it.
Just use that during the day?
I just use it in the morning when I wash my face.
What do you use at night?
There's another one I use for Ambi at night. It's for blotchy, because sometimes my skin gets blotchy because of the sun, so I use that at night.
Okay.
My next product is the Hair Infinity Pills.
Oh, does that work?
Do they work?
Now,
they
you
work.
Got to let me know, because I've been doing a lot of research on those Hair Infinity Pills, and they it's work. Been favorable. So
for
tell me.
For me, it wasn't about the length. It was about the volume, because I have thin hair.
Okay.
And especially after I press it out, since I don't get perm. So definitely, the length is good because it's growing, but it was more about the volume for me, so it wasn't so thin. And of course, my nails, she's always jealous because they grow so fast. So definitely, if you want to do your hair for the volume and the length, definitely use the Hair Affinity Pills.
Okay.
It has biotin in it, too. You can take biotin pills, but I love this as well, so you can take these. Lastly, these edges.
That's a show in and of itself, honey. Exactly. Edges and not hedges.
Carrot Hair.
That's cute.
This, what is this called? The Edge Tamer, and it tames these edges. I work out a lot. I do boxing twice a week, and we go hiking, and I just need to get these edges down. So definitely pick this up. And it's, you know, sometimes if you work out, you don't wash your hair in a week. So I only wash my hair once a week. It gets white and caked up with, like, the bad head. I love you, bad head, but it just doesn't work. This doesn't do that. You don't want to look like you got dandruff and all that going on.
What is
on,
that?
So.
Let me see. It's good. I used to use that one.
Yeah. That's definitely my three favorite products.
Perfect. Now, Nicole, what do you have good for us?
Okay. Something I put on every day. That's just always watching me in the bathroom. Right. I'm like this. It's my Moroccan Oil Intense Curl Cream.
It smells great.
It does. It keeps your curls nice and tight. So every morning I'm doing my hair with this, and she's looking at me like I'm psycho.
Now, do you use it with water or without?
With water.
Okay.
Yeah, I just put it on my hand. I'm like this. Then I'm like this. You scrunching it just to make sure you get your curls. Don't do that. Every morning I'm like, can we go? She's like, wait, this curl.
This
I'm
is
like,
curl.
Yes, I use this every morning. I'm into organic deodorant now.
In LA where it's hot.
Keisha says that to me all the time. She's like,
is
your deodorant going to run out? Because I don't know if you ever did any research on deodorant, but yes, deodorant is sometimes not good for you. So let's try to stick to it. It's $19.99 at Kiehl's for this little bottle. But
that
it's amazing.
That bottle is $19.99. Yeah. And how long does that last?
I bought them in bulk, so I don't know.
Wait a minute. Did you just say that you bought them in bulk?
Yes.
From where?
From Kiehl's.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Like, would they come in a pack of 12 or
something? No.
Individually.
My father buys everything.
$20 a bottle.
Anyway, awesome. So it's great.
Okay.
It works for me, and I don't like women who smell funny, so this is great.
So now, how long does that one little bottle last?
I think it lasted you probably 3 weeks last time. Maybe.
And then we
had to go again. I think it lasted probably 3 weeks.
Okay,
it's a
roll on?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and what about the coverage? Is it good?
I've never had a problem. I always put on Facebook, though, I hope my deodorant don't run out today. It's like 100 and some degrees. It never runs out.
Okay.
Yes. So if you can switch to organic deodorant, do it for your health. That's what I would say. Be quiet.
They are so cute, you guys. These twins are, like, so cute.
Okay, and I'm obsessed with Kiehl's, so this is their daily moisturizer, because I don't like having dry skin. I hate when people walking
$40
outside.
$40 a bottle.
Yeah, I hate when people... $48. I hate when people walking outside, and, like, their elbows are ashy, their legs are ashy. If you put this one cream on your body, you'll be fine the entire day. I may get in my car and put my arm on my little in-between thing, and it'd be like, oh, it's grease. But I'm okay.
So it is a little greasy.
It is a little greasy. You should mix it with something, but you won't be ashy. I don't like to see people, men, women, children, don't have your feet going up. Yes, your feet ashy. That's not cool.
But you use that in the summertime as well?
Yes. Don't be ashy.
Got a little
oil, skirt. Shea butter.
Okay, so we're on a revolution, the no ash movement.
Yes, please.
And the revolution will be televised by these two.
Now, this girl.
Okay, I'm more difficult.
She got five.
I couldn't really narrow it down. Okay, I'm going to start with the easy one. We all know about the Maybelline Great Lash.
Yeah.
Okay, got to have
mother
that.
Uses that from back in the day.
Yes.
If it's not broke, don't fix it.
Exactly.
That is a good mascara.
Because I've tried all kinds of mascaras and always come back to this. Mm-hmm. I have my little Bobbi Brown kit. Kind of, yeah, everything's dirty because you can tell I use it. I only go by Bobbi Brown and Chanel. They're the only thing that works for me.
She's obsessed with Chanel. That's
yes. In this pack, I don't even want, it's embarrassing if I open it, but it's a little.
Is it eyeshadow?
It's eyeshadow, but it's a light, it's a medium and a dark, and then a glitter. I'm not a fan of glitter.
Neither am I.
Okay.
My sister, girl. Ooh, I can't stand glitter nails.
I can't stand glitter, nothing.
How you feel about black women in blue eyeshadow?
Okay, that's another segment. Nicole,
okay.
That's another segment, honey.
Okay.
Probably a part one and part two.
But, like, in this little compact, like, if I need to run out, just do my eyebrows, and if I'm out and it's something wrong, I could just do my eyes and do a liner. This blush or bronzer, I have to have it.
Mm-hmm. Both or just one?
One or the other or both at the same time.
Okay.
I'm light. So sometimes when you go outside, you need some color if you haven't been sun-kissed. So
I'm melanin deprived myself. So I think I'm sexy dark chocolate.
You got a little bit more than me. So
I think I'm sexy.
I think I am.
And then I grew up as a tomboy, but my mother, she's such a lady. She always walks around with lipstick and earrings on. I'm like, Mama, why? She's like, 'cause I'm married. I gotta stay married.
Girl. So,
in my adulthood, I've learned to love lipstick, and this one is the one I have on now. It's Milani. It's the Uptown Mauve. And
oh, I love Milani.
It goes on so smooth, and it feels good. It smells good,
and it's lasted too.
Yes.
Have you reapplied since you've been here?
Well, I did because I was drinking.
Oh, okay.
I was drinking,
but it still looks like. Fresh, like she just
all
applied.
Day, all day, it stays on. So I love it.
It's good. Now, you
Let me preface
this by saying, when she was pulling out her product, and this will kind of give you a clue as to what she's about to talk about. She's pulling out her product. I was like, girl, you about to fight us? This is totally a no violence zone. We might disagree, but we agree to disagree here.
Yeah, see, that goes back to our culture.
Right.
But this is Vaseline with cocoa butter in it. And I put it on at night. I put it on my hands, my elbows, my feet, put my socks on so that I can have smooth skin. Sometimes I put it on my face just, you know, when I've had the rough weeks, the dry weeks. But
For a fight, though.
Not for a fight, no.
She is such a lady.
No. She is. She's so cute.
But I love it, and it smells good. And, yeah, it has cocoa butter. I forgot to bring the cocoa butter. Everybody knows about the Palmers. You know,
yeah, the stick.
The stick. I can't do the stick. It's too the cakey.
You use the lotion?
Mm-hmm. I use the lotion or the oil.
Okay.
The oil's good.
Yeah
I do like the oil. At night. I don't do the oil during the day.
So you can look like chicken.
Right. Hello. Just put me in a deep fryer, honey.
Exactly.
No, I'm cool. Well, thank you so much, ladies, for coming in. It has been an absolute pleasure. Thank you, Nikisha. Thank you, Nicole. And thank you, Shayla.
Thank you for having us.
And if we want to get in contact with you, please let us know how we would do so.
Oh, Lord.
You go for that, Keisha.
This is Nikisha on Twitter. I am Celeste and Twins 1. On Instagram, I am Produce Her, Keish, K-I-S-H. And on Facebook, we are the Celestin Twins.
And your website is?
And our website is CelestinTwins.com.
And Celestin is spelled?
C-E-L-I-S-T-A-N. This is Nicole. On my Instagram, I am Darling Nikki Coco, like the Prince song, Darling Nikki, and then Coco, C-O-C-O. On Instagram, I'm sorry, on Facebook, it's just my name, Nicole Elise Celestin. She spelled her name already. That's it for me. You?
My website, ShaylaHale.com, S-H-A-Y-L-A-H-A-L-E. Twitter and Instagram is the same, Shayla_Hale.
Perfect. Well, thank you, ladies. It has definitely been a very interesting conversation. And always remember, we keep the conversation going all week long on social media at It's BTV on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And our hashtag is always Beyond the Vanity. So be sure to put your 2 cents in and contact us during the week and visit us online at www.beyondthevanity.com. Set your alarms because we are here each and every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on LA Talk Live. And next week, we're going to be talking about cruelty-free beauty products. I was a biology major, so I was a little desensitized to the whole movement before. But we've got top beauty bloggers, Jen Matthews of My Beauty Bunny, Tashina Combs, and Ashley Piper coming in. And we are going to get schooled, educated, and they're going to take us to church on what it is and why cruelty-free is so important. So I'm Indian Tyler, reminding you that when you look at yourself in the mirror, always go beyond the reflection that you see with the naked eye. Go beyond the vanity. Your true beauty lies within. But mascara never hurt nobody. Okay.
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.